Demonstrated in this animation is a variation of the Millard Rotation Advancement Repair to close a left complete cleft lip. The Millard repair is the most common technique for cleft lip closure. Prior to making the first incision, the lip is first marked to properly plan incision placement. Points 1 are the edge of the lip commissure on both sides. Points 2 and 4 mark the lateral edges of the cupid's bow. Point 3 is the midpoint of the cupid's bow. Points 7 are the lateral aspect of the lateral nasal ala. Point 5 is placed such that the distance between points 7 and 5 is equidistant to the length between 7 and 2. The distance between 1 and 2 and 1 and 5 should be approximately equivalent. Point 8 is made 3/5 of the distance across the columella. Point 6 is the most superior and medial aspect of the lip skin available. Point 9 is variable depending on how much additional length is needed to drop the lip down for aligned closure. Keep in mind that the distance connecting 4, 8, and 9 is slightly longer than 5 and 6 as the rotation flap never unfurls perfectly straight. In this animation, you will see that the M and L lip flaps being discarded, though in actuality, these will be used to help with mucosal lining during closure. The red lines drawn here denote the planned incisions based on these markings. The back cut along the columella is variable depending on how much additional length is needed to drop the lip down for aligned and symmetric closure. Once the skin incisions have been made and the skin flaps undermined, the orbicularis muscle is detached on both sides from the nasal sill region. Once freed, the muscle layers are carefully and precisely closed with special emphasis along the white roll. The lateral cleft side flap is an advancement flap, while the medial non-cleft side is effectively a rotational flap.